Hello everyone, welcome back to the Syntax UK YouTube channel. My name is Matt and today I'm going to be talking about pairing the RME Digiface USB with the Ferrofish Pulse 16 to create a simple high-end recording setup for composers and producers who rely on a large number of hardware instruments. Now, if you are a composer or producer that uses a lot of analog synthesizers, drum machines, or studio outboard, then the Ferrofish Pulse 16 is the perfect device for you. It's got 16 TRS inputs and 16 TRS outputs, and this pairs perfectly with the small size of the Digiface USB to slide into any setup perfectly. Now, if you use microphone preamps, there are none available on this setup. So for something like that, you might require something like the RME quad mic or any of the other mic preamps that RME do. So let's talk about why this is such a great little setup. It consists of two devices, as I said, the Digiface USB and the Pulse 16. And if you are a composer who is using a large number of synthesizers or other instruments, especially in a small studio environment, you'll find that you are unplugging them, plugging them back in, swapping them over all the time based on what you need to use. Now, the Pulse 16 takes this issue away. It's got so many line level inputs and outputs, 16 on both sides in fact, and that is perfect for people that have loads of instruments that they want to have plugged into their computer and their interface all at once basically. With 16 TRS inputs and outputs too, this means that you could make use of the Pulse 16 for studio effects outboard gear. As well as if you had an analog mixer, for instance, you could use it as the front end to get this into your computer recording setup. So the Pulse 16 is not just about being able to get hardware instruments into your DAW and computer, it could also be useful for getting old analog gear into the digital age. Aside from the 16 line level inputs and outputs, we also have ADAT connections, and the ADAT connections are something that we're going to utilize in this setup because it allows us to add a tiny little interface like the Digiface USB. The Digiface USB offers 66 channels of audio in total, 32 in, 34 out. And the reason it can offer all those channels in such a small interface is that it only uses digital ADAT connections. So we have 8 ADAT ports in total, 4 in, 4 out, and each of those ports are capable of transporting 8 channels of audio. So that means we can get obviously 32 channels of audio in and 32 channels of audio out, which means with only 4 ADAT cables, we can get the full 16 channel audio stream from the Pulse 16. As I said, there's 34 channels on the output side, and the extra 2 channels account for the headphone port, which is a really quick and simple way of being able to monitor everything that's coming in and out of your interface. Pulse 16 also features a headphone port, so that gives you 2 headphone monitoring options, which is great if you're collaborating with someone as well and you need 2 ports. And finally, you have the USB 2 connection. Now, this provides all the power that the Digiface USB needs, as well as being the only connection that is required from your interface to your machine. And that means that there's so few cables you actually need to get a great deal of audio into your computer and DAW. And that's perfect, especially in a small studio environment where you don't need cables dragging everywhere. Let's talk about the Pulse 16. Now, the Pulse 16 is something that we've covered quite extensively on the YouTube channel as well as on our website recently, but that's because it is such a fantastic converter unit. If you haven't already seen it, make sure that you check out our product overview video for the Pulse 16 on our YouTube channel. It goes into real depth about the different versions of the Pulse 16 available, and that includes the Pulse 16, as I've got here, the Pulse 16 MX, which features a MADI SFP, as well as the Pulse 16 DX, which features all of that plus Dante connectivity. Now, the MX and DX will probably not suit home users or small studios, but they're great, especially if you already have the Pulse 16. You can get the MADI SFP as an optional extra if you ever require it. Ferrofish have also just released the Pulse 16 CV range, which for people that have modular synthesizers and other equipment that can take CV data, it has DC coupled output so that you can send that CV data to your modular synthesizers. If you require more channels than the 16 available on the Pulse 16, you can either daisy chain 2 together for 32 channels, or you could simply go for Ferrofish's flagship converters, the A32, which offer 32 channels in and 32 channels out. So they've got a vast range of converters which can suit any situation really, but the Pulse 16 for most people's uses is perfect, especially at the price point. So I've mentioned how simple it is to get all set up, and I'm just going to show you just how easy that can be. Go from your output on your synthesizer, like this one up here, straight into the inputs on the Pulse 16. It's as simple as that. And then we'll go from there, the ADAP ports on the Pulse 16 out to the interface. So as I said earlier, all it requires from interface to computer is one USB cable like this. Simply plug it in, you're ready to go. On the other end, all we need are these tiny ADAC cables. And by connecting these two like so, I've now got 8 channels in and 8 channels out of my interface. It's as simple as that. So now that we've done that, all we need to do is download the drivers for the Digiface USB from the RME website. Now, that is another great thing about RME interfaces. Their drivers are so reliable, they are rock solid, and they're constantly being updated. So it doesn't matter whether you've got an old machine or a new machine, you will have a driver that works perfectly for your particular machine. So I'm just going to go to the RME website. I'm going to go to the download section. And I'm going to choose Digiface USB. And then I'm just going to go down here and I'm going to choose Mac and then download the top driver. Then once this is downloaded, I can follow the package that is downloaded and then it will prompt me to restart the machine. Just so you know, if you're using Mac High Sierra or above, or you have one of the Mac M1 chip computers, then you will be needing to follow some extra steps to get your RME interface working. And we've linked that in the description below for you to check out. Now that we've downloaded and installed the driver, we have Total Mix and we have Fireface USB settings. And Fireface USB settings is the first thing we're going to open up because we need to make sure that we have a sync between our interface and the Pulse 16. So in the Fireface USB settings here, as I said, you can have control over the output format of all the optical outputs, as well as indicators down the bottom here in the input status, which tells you whether there is a sync or not. And then we have the clock mode here, which is what we're going to adjust. Now I'm going to choose the sample rate to be 48,000 hertz or 48 kilohertz. And the clock source is going to be set as internal, which means that your Digiface USB will be the master clock for all devices that are connected to it. So now on the Pulse 16 as well, we can just go onto the menu system, choose clock, and just check that the clock source is set to ADAT and also says 48 kilohertz, which it does, which means we're getting a sync. Now that we've done that, we know that we're going to be getting audio that is perfectly synced between these two devices. We can check out Total Mix. As I said, Total Mix is RME's routing and mixing software, and it's really powerful. I'm just going to show you the basics of it now. So this is the Total Mix window for the Digiface USB. Now, Total Mix is broken up into 3 distinct sections. You have hardware inputs, which is up the top line here. And those are all the physical inputs of your interface. We have the hardware outputs, which are the physical outputs of your interface. And this group in the middle here is the software playback channels. Now this covers everything from the audio coming from your DAW, media players like Spotify and iTunes, as well as web pages that might be playing audio like YouTube or anything like that. So my synthesizer up here is playing a chord progression so that it can be seen constantly in Total Mix. And you can see it up here in hardware inputs in ADAT channel 1. Now, all we need to do to get this to the Pulse 16 is to choose one of these hardware outputs here. I'm going to choose ADAT 1 and 2, and then just turn up the synthesizer here. And you can see it's now appeared in hardware output channel ADAT 1 and 2. Now if I just show you on the front of the Pulse 16 now, we can see a signal coming through. And the great thing about Total Mix is that it doesn't matter where you're routing things, you can have an infinite number of submixes. So I can now go to ADAT 3 and 4 output, for instance, and then I can route this synthesizer here again. As simple as that. Another fantastic feature of the Pulse 16 is those 16 TRS outputs as well. So if you've got multiple pairs of monitors, you could plug these into the outputs on the Ferrofish Pulse 16. And of course, you could go and have up to 8 pairs of monitors should you desire. And again, this is all controllable through Total Mix. You could set ADAT 1 and 2 to be your main monitors, for instance. ADAT 3 and 4 could be smaller monitors, and you know, the list goes on like that. Now, if you are someone who uses a lot of synthesizers, you may already have a MIDI interface. And if you've got a MIDI interface, that means you can plug MIDI into that interface from the Pulse 16 to get access to Ferrofish's RemoteFish software. Being able to work on your monitor makes it far easier to just see where things are being routed, and it also allows you to save presets quite easily. And these presets can of course be recalled and saved on the Pulse 16 too. You can get up to 6 preset slots. So the Digiface USB and the Pulse 16 together create a simple, high-end but compact recording solution for people with hardware instruments, as well as for people with effects outboard, and for just bringing new life into old analog gear. It's worth mentioning though, of course, you do not need the Digiface USB to get the most out of the Pulse 16. It can be an expansion to any existing interface as long as there are those ADAT connections available. One of the great things about the Digiface USB, as we've said, is that you'll get the full 16 channels out of the Pulse 16 through 4 ADAT connections, and that leaves you 4 ADAT connections for expansion. So if you ever do need mic preamps, like we mentioned at the start of this video, the Digiface USB has room to grow with your studio.